Ladies and gentlemen, Sissy Spacek.
The first time I ever met Loretta Lynn, I felt like I'd known her all my life. I remember when I was working on Coal Miner's Daughter, and I had to learn Loretta's songs. So she and I got a hotel room in Nashville, and we pinned all the lyrics of the songs to the lampshades. And we sang those songs and played those songs for days, just walking from lampshade to lampshade. The hardest thing I had to do after we finished making Coal Miner's Daughter was to stop being Loretta. I loved being you, Loretta. I could have gone on being you for the rest of my life. But everybody in the world knows there's just one Loretta Lynn, and she's sitting right up there with the president. I'm proud to be a part of this celebration, but I'm prouder still to call Loretta my friend.
Appalachia, 1934. The mines and the hollers were all Loretta knew. She was born to a coal miner's family in a house bursting with 8 kids, love, and song. At 13, she met Doolittle Lynn. In a month, they were married. Soon, they were living in Washington State. 4 babies in 5 years. Life was canning peaches and singing the kids to sleep at night. Doo loved her voice. He bought her a guitar and took her to town. The tough bar crowd stopped to listen. Let the drifting whispering sing. Whispering sing. Making it up as they went along, she and Doo hit the road with a homemade record and a list of radio stations on the dashboard. Loretta charmed her way in the door and left every DJ with a single and a 1,000-watt smile. 3,000 miles later, Honky Tonk Girl hit number 14 on the Billboard charts.
But now I'm a honky tonk girl.
Next stop, the capital of country. Most girl singers weren't writing their own songs or speaking their own minds.
You thought that
over, boys, this gal could swing.
With loving on your mind, you come to tell me something you say I ought to know.
A favorite on the Grand Ole Opry and a top 10 spin on every roadhouse jukebox.
You say you're gonna take him, oh, but I don't think you can, 'cause you ain't woman enough to take my man.
She was a fresh breeze that blew the lid off country music.
And you can't afford to turn it down, 'cause you know I've got the pill.
They tried to shut her down, but they couldn't shut her up. And women loved her for it.
The feeling good comes easy now, since I've got the pill.
She
She was born a coal miner's daughter, but she has become a country music legend. Miss Loretta Lynn.
You don't see no city when you look at me, 'cause country is all I am. I love a running barefooted through the old corn.
Familiar as a friend across the kitchen table, Loretta is the plain spoken pride of country. Our country.
Ladies and gentlemen, the 41st President of the United States, George Bush.
Thank you very much. Thank you all very much.
First, I want to set everyone's mind at ease that we have some highly trained professionals who will follow me and handle the actual musical tribute to Loretta. And so I will spare you my own special rendition of Who Was That Stranger? And though I come from a musically oriented family, I'm afraid there was a genetic power outage in my case. There's no note I can sing, no beat I can hold, and I can't tell if the president is laughing, but the truth be told, he's a couple of quarts low on musical talent, too. So, tonight we're honoring the girl from Butcher Holler, who today is one of the reigning queens of country music. She's an American original, and her timeless body of work has helped us celebrate what this country and its amazing people are all about. And so I feel very confident in speaking for the entire Bush family and expressing our love and our respect for this national treasure, Loretta. Thank you for your decency, your music, and your friendship. God bless you. Thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, Reba McEntire.
And this little girl would walk a country mile to find her a good old slow-talking country boy. I said, a country boy. Well, I'm about as old-fashioned as I can be, and I hope you're liking what you see. But if you're looking at me, you're looking at country. You don't see no city when you look at me, 'cause the country's all I am. I love a running barefooted through the old cornfields, and I love that a country ham. Well, you say I'm a maid just to fit your plans, but does a barnyard shovel fit your hands? If you're looking at Loretta, you're looking at country.
Ladies and gentlemen, Garth Brooks and Trisha Yearwood.
Hey, Louisiana woman.
Mississippi man, we get together every time we can. Mississippi River can't keep us apart.
There's too much love in this Mississippi heart.
Too much love in this Louisiana heart.
We'll see the alligator there waiting nearby. Sooner or later, they know I'm gonna try. But when she waves from the bank, don't you know I know it's a goodbye fishing line. See you while I go. With the Louisiana woman waiting on the other side, the Mississippi River don't look so wide. Mississippi heart.
Too much love in this Louisiana heart. Yeah. Well, I thought I'd been loved, but I never had, till I was wrapped in the arms of a Mississippi man. Mississippi man, I'm losing my mind. Gotta have your loving one more time. If you can't come to me, I'm gonna go to him. That Mississippi River, Lord, I'm gonna swim.
Louisiana woman. Too much love in this Mississippi heart.
Too much love in this Louisiana heart.
Ladies and gentlemen, Lyle Lovett.
Well, if you've been a divorce is the key to being loose and free, so you're gonna be talked about. All the women all look at you like you're bad, the men all hope you are. But if you go too far, you're gonna wear the scar of a woman rated X. And if you're rated X, you're some kind of gold. So we're trying to make, but I think it's wrong to judge every picture if a cheap camera makes a mistake. And when your best friend's husband says to you that you started looking good, you should have known he would, and he would if he could, and he will if you're ready. Women don't have a chance, 'cause if you've been married, you can't have no fun at all. You're rated X.
Ladies and gentlemen, Patti Loveless.
Loretta, I'm proud of you. And I'm too proud to be a coal miner's daughter.
Well, I was born a coal miner's daughter in a cabin on a hill. Shovel coal to make a poor man's dollar. My daddy worked all night in the Van Deer coal mines, all day long in the field hoeing corn. Mommy rocked the baby at night, read the Bible by the coal light, and everything would start all over come break of morn. Yeah, I'm proud to be a coal miner's daughter. I remember well the well where I drew water. The work we done was hard, at night we sleep 'cause we were tired. I never thought of ever leaving Butcher Holler. Well, a lot of things have changed since way back then, and it's so good